This is the first U.S. Open women's final between the top two seeds since 1998. The Lindsay Davenport, the number two seed, beat Martina Hingis, the number one seed. Tonight it's Serena, number one, Venus, number two. Venus will begin the match serving. Here's the first point in the women's finals. On the first point, a double fault to start for Venus.
Well, I'm sure both players are extremely nervous. I mean, what an amazing ceremony we had. Unbelievable crowd, packed stadium, nearly 23,000 people to watch these two.
And 2-1 forced errors for Venus to start this match.
Sam, I was here this morning, saw Venus practicing with her hitting partner. Came back this evening, they were both warming up together.
And right off the bat, it's Serena with three break chances in the opening game.
Starting out like she has in her other matches during these 2 weeks.
Saying that she's been absolutely ferocious. Up her first point in this match.
15-4.
Coming to the net, she's been very successful in these 2 weeks up at the net. Wow, this crowd's already into the match.
Venus has fought off two break points, but still a chance for Serena, who got up love 40 in this game. And so Venus settles down nicely. Frame of mind here, Kathy, because it seemed at Wimbledon they at least made that match competitive. They seem to be getting over some of this mystique they have about playing against each other.
Well, I'm sure in the beginning when they started playing each other in the finals of these tournaments, so much buildup, so much talk, so many questions. I mean, you got to remember they're best friends, they're sisters. It's nerve-wracking.
Serena Williams.
Can't imagine playing my brother or sister, you know, for a world title, let alone the number one world ranking. Of course, they've got nerves and they've got feelings.
Now, Venus has fought off four break points in this opening game.
Well, if the trend continues like this, Sam, we're in for one heck of a match. Venus being very aggressive, that's what she's got to do.
She hasn't lost a point at the net so far. Picks up her first ace to get her first game point.
Again, the serve helping her out.
95 miles an hour out wide. And it's Venus Williams who survives the opening game. A little shaky start, but she gets through it. She leads one love. Serena's talked about in her press conferences this week a different mentality once she steps on the court, how much more ferocious she is than the way she lives her life off the court. But against Venus, who knows?
Serena Williams.
And we'll see Serena Williams serve for the first time tonight.
Well, like I said, I think it's going to come down to the serve and the big returns.
Mother Orosine in the center of your picture.
Boy, what must be going through her mind? She must just be so incredibly proud.
So Richard Williams out watching the John McEnroe-Boris Becker challenge match before this began.
Serve out wide. Look how early she catches that ball. The power she creates.
30-15. And now 30-all. Serena Williams, the number one seed. Only once in the past 5 years has the number one seed won the title in a Grand Slam. Not just in the U.S. Open. Number one seed has not fared that well recently. For Capriati finally breaking that streak in Australia this year as the Australian Open champion. Well, then you had to go back to the 98 Australian Open when Martina Hingis won it as the number one seed. Too close for comfort, but it works. It's one all to start this championship.
Both players looking pretty impressive in these first couple of games, not holding back. Then again, we never see him holding back, do we?
It's all out all the time. So well is the fact that they do know each other's game so well, and that should produce very exciting points because of their anticipation. Once they get over the nerves, we should have some really good rallies. There's the hand of Venus Williams, which if you saw her semifinal match, she had a blister. She's got it taped again tonight.
Well, you're right about that, Sam. I mean, these girls practice with each other. They warm up together just like before tonight's match. They know each other's games inside out. They know their favorite shots, their weaknesses. So it should produce some great tennis.
Well, Venus starting this game much more successfully than she did her first service game. Shot, isn't she? And now 40 love. Each sister with four unforced errors. Herself to avoid hitting the net.
40-50.
Be careful approaching here.
She was in control of this point. Boom.
Still game points for Venus.
Oh,
And I don't think there's any doubt they both want to win this. And the intensity with which they're playing right now.
Right from the very first point.
Still game point, 40-30. Has held to start this match twice. She leads 2-1 in Arthur Ashe Stadium at the USTA National Tennis Center Women's Championship.
What a display of power and shots we've seen so far in just the first three games.
The two have produced seven winners in the opening three games.
And you know, Sam, I think as they've played more matches and especially for these big titles, I think the quality of tennis just keeps rising and gets better and better.
I mean, you would know better than me since you know both of them personally, but I'm not picking up on any nerves out here. It looks to me like they're trying to just crush the ball.
Absolutely. I mean, it's just been pure power. They keep this up, this could be one of the best matches ever.
Wimbledon score was 7-6, 6-3 in favor of Venus. Excuse me, in favor of Serena. Then at the French Open, Serena won 7-5, 6-3. The scores have been getting a little closer and closer each time they've played.
Well, it's been Serena in the press conference early on in the tournament that said, you know, Venus has been playing great all summer. She's really been beating up on me in practice. So everyone seems to have been picking Serena just by going from her form in the last couple of weeks here at the championships.
The two-time defending champion there, Venus Williams, has held serve twice. She puts the pressure back on little sister Serena. Serena Williams now will serve at 1-2 in the opening set.
From that shot.
It's her first winner off that backhand side, but I'm sure it won't be her last. Has been the hottest player on the tour since losing that final at Wimbledon to her sister. She hasn't lost a match since then. She's won three titles coming into the U.S. Open. And now 40 love for Serena. Nine.
And that's one aspect of Serena's game that she has improved tremendously is the serve. She's had a ton of aces throughout this championships.
It's her first ace. She had 13 against Davenport yesterday. Double fault. Also her first. Still comfortably ahead, 40-15 in this game.
Thank you.
There's up the line.
Well, it's Serena that we'll see more emotion from tonight. Much more emotional player than her sister Venus. Venus keeps everything inside.
Good or bad.
But to me, Sam, it seems that Serena's much more comfortable out there on the center stage. She loves this kind of atmosphere.
Which goes along with that type of personality.
Absolutely.
Much more extroverted. One thing Venus has struggled with in this tournament, it has been her serve. She's double faulted quite a few times. She had 10 double faults yesterday against Muresmo. This is her third against her sister, and it's love 30.
But that's what she's been able to do. Yeah. You know, everybody's talked about Venus's serve and how it's let her down, but she's been able to come up with a big serve to dig herself out of trouble, just like she did in this very first game of this match.
I don't think so. But now it's Serena again with great chances. 15-40 at 2-all. Serena had 4 break points in the opening game of the match. Now she misses out on converting her 5th. Not by much.
Well, this is the one shot that has gone from Venus. She's lost her way with that forehand. Seems to be on back on track with it.
Still a break point, 30-40.
Oh, that is just incredible.
Now this is what we've all waited for. They are not backing down from each other.
How Venus got back into that point and controlled it. Shows her power that she can get even off balance.
And Serena confirming it was out. Give her another break point.
Just wide. I tell you, I would not want to be the linesman tonight.
And the speed with which it hit the court.
Seemed to fire Venus up a little bit.
Now you can say that Serena has not converted on 7 break points, but it's been Venus who has been saving them. Big shots.
Forehand. Venus's approach to Serena's forehand every time except for then.
Now game point for Venus Williams. Well, Venus has struggled a bit more on serve, but she's getting the job done. And she maintains a slight lead here in the opening set. Five games, Kathy. This has been great. Really high level of tennis.
What a display of shots we've seen. But you've got to wonder how many times Venus can give those great points away. She's going to have to be careful.
The girls checking out the Jumbotron. The Jumbotron showing some of the American celebrities here in the crowd.
That was Hank Aaron.
All-time great baseball players, most home runs any baseball player here in the United States. See the break points. Venus had 7. No conversions.
Well, Venus doesn't want to make a habit of getting down those break points, though, Sam. It's just a matter of time before Serena can connect on one.
Around a little bit more on this changeover than she normally does. She keeps her eyes down in her lap, brings that little piece of paper, goes through some meditation.
See, the paper's there. She hasn't read it yet. Very difficult match situation for both girls. They handle it so extremely well.
Yes. The next word's out of my mouth. We have stayed on serve in this opening set. And Serena has had seven chances to break. Now she'll have to hold a 2-3 in the first set of the 2002 U.S. Open Women's Singles Championship. Becoming the 10th woman in tennis history to win the French and Wimbledon back-to-back. And a U.S. Open to those two. Here at 15-30. His first serve percentage at 50%. Came on the air yesterday for the semifinals. The WTA Tour had said that Lindsay Davenport must beat Serena Williams for Venus to get the number one ranking back. However, they changed that today, recalculated it, and the winner of this match will in fact be the number one player in the world.
Just adds a little more drama to this match, as if it needed any more. Going for big returns, trying to get control of that point right from the go.
Instead, now game point for Serena to even this first set at 3-3. Seats very quickly in this stadium.
I have. There's none.
The toughest tickets in sports tonight. And even their unforced errors are impressive. I mean,
Well, both players right now overplaying a little bit. Getting to that crucial stage of the set.
Fourth double fault for Venus Williams.
She doesn't have real great racket acceleration. I like Serena's swing better. She kind of ducks her head. So keep that head up a bit longer.
And Serena breaks with an exclamation point. She takes control of the first set. 4-3.
4 games to 3.
I think she's seen that serve a few times before. Timed it perfectly. Kenny Navratilova being honored up on the Jumbotron screen. Great point, Serena finally getting a break point.
That's what I said, Sam. I wonder how long Venus could keep Serena off from breaking. She gets in trouble every service game. She's got to be careful.
Celebrity sightings on the Jumbotron screen, and even the Williams sisters checking it out. And really, Kathy, this is the first time I've seen them pay any attention at all to anything other than the court. So maybe they are quite relaxed tonight. They've finally gotten here.
I don't know. I think there's some nerves there. I mean, they're playing for an awful lot tonight. They might be relaxed because they're playing against each other, you know, their sisters, but there's a lot at stake in this match.
Do you buy into the whole line that the family wins here? As a former tour player yourself?
I don't know. You know, I don't know about that. Mm-hmm. I just look at my brothers and sisters, how competitive I am with them.
Thank you.
Now Serena Williams is taking control of this first set. She has broken her sister Venus and serves at 4-3.
She was happy that she lost those titles from her in her world number one ranking. But she was asked about that in the press conference, and she said, you know, asked if who she would rather play, Serena or Lindsay. She said, Serena. And they said, well, why? You lost with her twice now. And she said, because I want to see her do her personal best. And they do put family before tennis.
Yeah.
Parents have done a great job.
Venus still with a good chance in this game. 15-30, trying to get that break right back from Serena.
She needs to.
Oh, it's called out.
Looked on the line.
two break points for Venus.
This is huge for Venus right now. She needs to get right back into the set. We've seen Serena when she gets out ahead. Just keep it rolling.
Serena has broken just once yesterday against Lindsay Davenport. Now another second serve at 15-40, 4-3, first set.
That has just been a hot shot for Serena Williams. I have never seen her use this shot as much as she has in the championships. Takes a little pace off the ball. It's a little shorter, but look at the angle. Right on the line.
Still break point, 30-40. She finally got the break. Venus did it on her second break point.
Successful up at the net. That lob's just way too short.
With the right idea, had she been able to get that up higher, Venus was definitely moving forward. You see again, she's had some really close calls on that baseline. Where's the ball? There it is. Too slow. You can hear Serena talking to herself. Oh, come on, Serena. Chance here. 30 all. Serena could break right back. She'll have that chance. We could see our third consecutive break.
And Sam, that's where Serena has it over Venus. She has a better service motion and she has a better serve.
Serve and she will serve for the opening set. 5-4.
Well, I really feel for Venus Williams. I mean, I think she wants this title so badly. She just overplayed that approach shot. And you know, Sam, there's been so many skeptics about, you know, the matches when they played each other. You know, people said, oh, they're fixed, and, you know.
Right.
I think this proves that. Well,
they're going for blood.
Yeah, they are.
They are playing hard out there. I don't think anyone would say that based on the way they're playing this match. Even with the breaks of serve, it's not like one sister's giving the other the games. See, Serena has had far more chances. But again, as we said to start, Venus's serve has been the only part of her game that has really not been very consistent. See the packed house in Arthur Ashe Stadium high above.
See, there's not one empty seat.
It's been a great day of tennis here at the U.S. Open. The men's semifinals were completed earlier. Andre Agassi and Pete Sampras will meet for tomorrow's men's singles championship.
Can you believe it?
It's great for American tennis.
Sure is, especially right here in New York.
And I think it's also great for the sport, because there will be millions of people watching that match tomorrow, just as they are tonight.
Oh boy, will the fans be split up rooting for both players.
And now Serena Williams serving for the opening set in this women's championship, 5-4. Winners have come from that backhand. The most lethal shot so far tonight.
There's been some close calls so far.
They've mostly involved Venus Williams. She has been flirting with that line all night.
Seeing tight calls with both these girls. They hit the ball so hard, so deep.
Set point for Serena Williams. 40 love at 5-4, first set. And she finishes the set with her second ace. Serena Williams has taken the opening set, 6-4. Of serve in that first set. Finally was able to serve it out.
Well, Sam, that last serve says it all. I mean, that's really been the difference in the match. Even though Serena's only at 41% first serves. Serena's only at 53%.
Here's the way it breaks down. 38 minutes of total time for the first set.
Double faults for Venus Williams. That's, and look at the unforced errors, 16 unforced errors. But really, I think it's been the serve. I mean, Serena's been able to have a lot more opportunities than Venus on the service games.
The serve also very much a factor in the amount of confidence the player has.
Absolutely. When you're serving well, your whole game seems to come together. And that's been the case for Venus Williams in this championships. And she's been serving well. She's been winning pretty easily. We saw her have trouble with it against Shonda Rubin, Emily Moresmo, and the errors kept coming.
girls need to do now? Just serve better? Yes, is that all it takes?
Well, that's a good start.
It'll be Venus Williams serving first in the second set. Let's see if she can rebound here. So under the lights. And the singles championship being contested at the National Tennis Center here in Flushing Meadows, New York. Serena Williams has now won 31 consecutive sets in Grand Slam tournaments. Venus Williams serving to start the second. Times in this match. Venus six.
Under a lot of pressure with that second serve. Guessing to the right. Guess what? Venus goes to the left.
Already you can tell the crowd here pulls for the sister that is behind. And these girls to stay out here as long as they can. Miss Williams, nice comeback in this game. Almost knocks her sister down.
Look how low she gets for those backhands.
Venus holds to start the second set. And a very good step from Venus Williams. Good throughout this whole tournament.
First serve and in her service games than Venus.
Oh. Just always attacking, Kathy.
The old 1-2 punch.
I don't think a replay can slow this down.
Well, look where she was off that return. She was looking for it.
No sooner than you blink, it's 40 love. Holds it love to start this second set. And one game apiece. Kathy, we talk all the time about the men's tennis and how much more powerful the men are, but interesting statistic. Venus Williams' average first serve speed has been 107 miles an hour. And in the Agassi-Hewitt semifinal today, neither player's average speed was over 106. And serves. She's hitting it just as hard as the men.
Wow. That says a lot.
Hewitt's average first serve speed was 106. Agassi's was 103.
The problem is, though, is that Venus isn't getting a high enough percentage of first serves in, especially at the moment.
50%. Seventh trip into the net for Venus. I recommend doing this more often.
Why not? She's pretty successful up it there. 5 out of 7 points, one up at the net. She's pretty intimidating up there. Long reach, hard to get the ball over her head. But this is really letting her down tonight.
Well, that may be the next step for Venus. Develop that serve and volley game a little more.
It's her eighth double fault of the evening.
Regardless of what you think, Serena Williams has just been the better player.
She has. She's been much more solid tonight.
It's still early in the second set. This could turn around. Venus must get this second serve in to avoid going down a break.
Venus lucky to get out at this point.
Not staying down through that shot. Another great chance for Serena Williams. It's just the third game of the second set.
Big opportunity now for Serena.
And a double fault with Serena Williams, an early break here in the second set. 9 double faults for Venus. Again, she had a total of 10 yesterday over 3 sets against Maresma.
Sam, you've got to wonder how frustrating this. If Venus should lose this match, how frustrating for her this must be. I mean, she's the older sister. She was the one that everybody first talked about being the number one player. Great expectations. You know, Serena's already got 2 titles under her belt this year. This would be Venus's 3rd loss to Serena this year. You got to wonder.
And Venus Williams with 4 total Grand Slam singles titles from Wimbledon and the U.S. Open in back-to-back years. It's been Serena with 3 titles in her first U.S. Open here in 99. And as Kathy said, the French and Wimbledon this year. So Serena with 1 more to catch up with Venus. Serena Williams up an early break here in the second set. She got up a break in the first set. Venus was able to break back.
Thank you.
Scene in the middle. I just was told that Richard has gotten up and left. He's too nervous.
It's got to be nerve-wracking. Morrison's got her shades on, so we can't see what she's thinking, huh? Can't see her eyes.
Covered up over there. It's a very hot afternoon, but very comfortable right now. We'll see how ferocious Serena is here. She's got her sister down.
At the moment has really lost her way here. She needs to find herself, and she needs to find herself soon.
Now 40-15, a chance to consolidate that break for Serena, move ahead 3-1.
Just no weaknesses in her game.
This is the stage two where you think if there was any apprehension from Serena, it would start to show itself. Rally got louder and louder.
Well, this is the biggest game of the match for Venus right now to stay into it. She needs to hold. And believe me, this crowd wants to see it go the length.
Set matches against each other. It's won one of those. It's been a while since 99. Serena has just been the better player. Say it over and over again.
She's doing everything a little bit better than Venus. Overpowering, putting everything she's got into every shot.
And now three break points. Venus comes up with a big backhand.
Right now she's got to just take one shot at a time, just like this backhand. Look at the angle she gets from that far behind the baseline. It's just incredible.
the clock called on Venus Williams.
Oh, come on, give the big sister a break.
Second serve. She leads 4-1, second set.
Well, right now she's just not giving her sister any respect, is she?
No, she's not. But
typical little sister, because I'm a little one.
I'm sure my little brother would be doing the same thing, but it's still fun to watch. I just cannot remember ever seeing anyone dominate in this fashion. Sure, we've had Navratilova, Steffi Graf, and they've all had their own styles. This is a unique style in women's tennis, the way she's playing and the way she's winning.
Well, we just have never seen such a display of power. And she really just doesn't have any weaknesses. I mean, I keep saying that, but it's, you know, people ask me, what do you do to beat Serena Williams? Well, you've got to just hope that she's going to be off a little bit.
Maybe trip her a second.
But really what she's doing, she's outserved Venus. I mean, her second serve is just much better. It's still a weapon. And that's where Venus really needs to reevaluate after this championships. Needs to make the improvements that Serena has. She really concentrated on her serve and has really improved it.
And you would think that now would be the time for Venus Williams, as you said, to take stock of what's going on in her game and try to make some changes.
And that's hard to do. I mean, she's been so successful and so dominant herself. She's really just had the trouble with her sister Serena.
And Venus Williams has not lost a match since the Wimbledon finals. She won 3 U.S. Open tune-up events. Stanford, San Diego, and New Haven the week before the U.S. Open. Serena had some tendonitis in one of her knees. Unable to play a lot heading into the Open, but she has been the dominant player of the U.S. Open to this point. And she's now up a set in 2 breaks in the second.
Thank you.
Serena fan, but we got plenty of Venus fans out here as well.
All over.
This is definitely their night. That volley to the open court.
Well, she's winning 3 out of every 4 points when she comes into the net.
Just getting the opportunities to get up there.
Now a couple of break chances for Venus. 15-40. I think that's what this crowd wants to happen. Serena. Her sister has been footfaulted.
Second
seat behind Serena this match, now an hour old. Stay quiet in between the serves. Back. And after that changeover, Kathy, she kind of a little smirk on her face. I have to say, I'm not out of this. Coming back.
Well, we've seen her do it before.
See if she can get control of her serve, however. That's been the problem. She's serving now at 2-4.
Took a little pace off that. I think that's what she needs to do. Find the rhythm. Get the rhythm going in the serve. Take a little pace off.
The 29th unforced error for Venus Williams. Unforced errors for Serena. Pretty all, Venus just unable to get any distance between her and Serena.
Needs to close the gap right now. She needs this game to do it.
Seems like she can't really get ahead in these service games, but she does have a beam point now. But can she win 2 points in a row? Second set. Serena still up a break.
I'm wondering if Venus feels more pressure on her shoulders, being the older sister, having more expectations on her than Serena being the younger sister, you know?
Yeah, I think initially that was would definitely be the case, especially in the first few meetings between these two, but now it almost seems like Venus would be mad. You know, I mean, her little sister's beaten her in the last two Grand Slams.
She's the only person standing in her way from these titles and from this world number one ranking.
You think maybe she would use some of that big sister voodoo on her little sister? You know how the big sibling always has a little bit of an intimidation factor over a younger sibling?
No, I don't know that.
Well, you can't tell me, Kathy. Is it your brother?
But, you know, us babies of the family get away with murder. But what a night for these girls. I mean, you just feel for both of them. Being a parent, I just can't even imagine what their mother and father must be going through right now. I mean, we heard Richard say he's so nervous, I've got to get out of here.
Tom.
Well, I guess in that role, you would just be the peacemaker. Try to keep everybody happy. And right now, Serena Williams has lost one of her two breaks. She will still have a break in the second set. 4-3. And then her third. consecutive Grand Slam. I think the seventh woman in tennis history to do it. If she can win this match. Shot there, too much into it.
I think if I were Venus, with all the success she's having up there, I'd try and get up there as much as possible.
So much fun to watch. Ace down the middle. Number three for Serena.
This is too good, Sam.
And now 40-15, a chance to move ahead to 5-3. She does. And now Serena Williams is a game away from the U.S. Open title. And it's Venus who must hold to stay in this match. And you know the fans realize it. Trying to get behind Venus. Shot on the baseline, called out. Serena takes the opening point. One thing about Serena, you almost never see her give up in a point.
She gets almost everything back.
She goes way off the court, but just sending a message that, hey, at least I can get a racket on.
Showing off that athleticism.
15 all. Baseline, and now Serena, 2 points from the championship. And now 2 championship points for Serena Williams. Trying to win her second U.S. Open and her third consecutive Grand Slam title. No emotion in the family box over there. 15-40, 3-5.
Oh my goodness.
How's that for some drama? A second serve ace. But still, the championship point for Serena at 30-40. Championship points gone. There it is, Serena Williams, the seventh player in tennis history to win three consecutive Grand Slam titles.
Serena Williams and Venus Williams.
She is the 2002 U.S. Open champion and remains the number one player in the world.
Serena and Venus. It's now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Merv Heller, President and Chairman of the Board of the United States Tennis Association. Merv?
Thanks, Tony. The USTA's theme for this year was Celebrate the American Tennis Spirit. And I can't think of a better day than today, Super Saturday, when we celebrated that American tennis spirit. What do you think? My vision for the USTA is to take tennis to the people. And the two finalists we had tonight embody that vision. Let's hear it for those two that are taking tennis to the people. I also want to thank very much our sponsor tonight, JP Morgan Chase. Not only are they great for women's sports, but just great for women's tennis, and we appreciate their partnership with us in this US Open Championships. Tonight, it was a battle for three, either a three-peat at the U.S. Open or three straight Grand Slams. Congratulations to both you, Serena, and Venus for a great, great match.
Venus, if you'd come up, please, and accept your trophy from Merv. In addition to this trophy, Venus will receive a check for $450,000 in prize money. Venus, congratulations on a wonderful tournament. It seemed like your serve did let you down a little bit tonight.
I don't think it was a serve. I think Serena just played too well. Everything I tried just wasn't the better player today.
Little sister's gotten a little better over the last year, hasn't she?
Oh, I'm proud of her.
Congratulations on a great tournament. Now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Bill Harrison, Chairman and CEO of J.P. Morgan Chase. Bill.
Thank you, Tony, and what a thrill it is for all of us to be here at this U.S. Open and to experience this magnificent evening of tennis in our great city of New York. We've had a wonderful... We've had a wonderful and exciting 2 weeks of tennis here. And with J.P. Morgan Chase's long history with women's tennis, we have been proud to have sponsored the Women's Singles Championship here again. And as I stood here last year on this very night, it was hard to imagine the inconceivable tragedy that was several days ahead of us on September the 11th. And yet tonight, as we stand here, I think all of us are heartened by how our great city and our great country have responded yet again to this terrible crisis. And the determination, the resiliency, the heart and soul of New York City and our country prevailed again. And when we think of heart and soul, I can't imagine many people that represent determination and heart and soul more than the Williams sisters. They have raised the bar in women's tennis, and I think that's what competition. And I think that's what competition in sports are and should be all about. So on behalf of J.P. Morgan Chase, I'm delighted to give the winner's check for $900,000 to a great champion who's won 3 Grand Slams this year. Serena, another wonderful performance. Congratulations.
Serena, the French, Wimbledon, now U.S. Open, 3 Grand Slams in 1 year. Absolutely phenomenal. Tell us how you feel right now.
Well, right now I'm just so happy. I would like to thank my God, Jehovah, for just blessing our family and just allowing me to, and my sister and just all of us just to be here. So I'm just elated right now.
I'm sure you have a lot of people here who have supported you that you'd like to thank.
Yeah, it's just everyone. My parents are just the backbone of our family, and I would like to say thanks, Daddy, and thanks, Mom, and everybody, all my sisters also, and Richard.
Serena, thank you very much. Congratulations. Now, once again, Merv Heller, I think you have a trophy for our champion. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2002 U.S. Open Wimbledon singles champion, Serena Williams.